Hi, I'm Soray Ferreira and welcome to StorySD episode number 63. Today's episode is dedicated to how you can use stories to entertain.
Welcome to StorySD, helping you use storytelling in your communication strategy. Explore other resources at storysd.com. And now, here is your host, Dr. Soray Ferreira, story strategy consultant and trainer.
Last year, when I was coming back from my summer vacations in Algarve, I was exiting the highway and right in front of me, there was an accident. So all of the cars had to stop because the accident was between a truck and a car. Behind me, there was even an ambulance that was trying to pass, but the ambulance couldn't pass because of the truck. So we were waiting to solve this problem. And at the same time, there was a fire right on my right side. So I could see the choppers coming and throwing water and I had ashes falling on top of me. So I was looking at the clock thinking, okay, I'm going to miss my flight, which I really didn't want. But after a couple of minutes, I guess the ambulance being there speed up the process, the path was cleared, and I barely made it to the airport on time. So this is a story that I tell my friends when they ask me, okay, so how was your vacations? The purpose of the story is really just to entertain. And these kinds of stories you tell every single day to your friends and family. So just pay attention that you are telling a story and try to improve the story with all of its elements. If you want to join the Storybank challenge that we are doing right now, just sign up for the newsletter and there you will get all of the info that you need.
Standing on the shoulder of giants.
The recommended resource for this episode is the book Sapiens, A Brief History of the Humankind by Yuval Harari. And in this book, there was one part that particularly caught my attention that has to do with the cognitive revolution. And Yuval said that the cognitive revolution was only made possible because humans were able to share myths and legends. And because of the sharing of these stories, they were able to cooperate in large numbers because they were able to believe in the fiction that they were creating. In the next episode, it's time to talk about how you can use stories to motivate. Until then, keep moving forward.
Thank you for tuning into StorySD. Sign up to the newsletter today and be the first to receive updates at storysd.com.